grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In this Eucharistic celebration, we celebrate the feast of St. James the Apostle. We pray for his intercessions to be firm in faith. There's a special intention for Mirna Lorena Abici Crown as they celebrate their birthdays. Coming together as God's family, frail and weak, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, as Blessed Mary of Everlasting, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me in the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone and the Lord, you alone and the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who consecrated the first fruits of your apostles, by the blood of St. James, grant, we pray, that your church may be strengthened by his confession of faith and constantly sustained by his protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, on God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we hold this treasure in earthen vessels, that the surpassing power may be of God and not from us. We are afflicted in every way, but not constrained, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying about in the body the dying of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our body. For we who live are constantly being given up to death for the sake of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So this is at work in us, but life in you. Since then, we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believe, therefore I spoke. We too believe and therefore speak, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. The word of the Lord. Response to your song. Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with rejoicing. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. You are glad indeed. Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those that sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back rejoicing, carrying their sheaves. Those who sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The mother of the sons of Zebedee approached Jesus with her sons, and he did him homage, wishing to ask him for something. He said to her, "What do you wish?" She answered him, "Command that these two sons of mine sit, one at your right and the other at your left in your kingdom." Jesus said in reply, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the chalice that I am going to drink?" They said to him, "We can." He replied, "My chalice you will indeed drink, but to sit at my right and at my left, this is not mine to give, but is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at the two brothers. But Jesus summoned them and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and the great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just so, the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Thank you. As I had mentioned in the beginning, that today we celebrate the Feast of St. James. It's known as St. James the Great because he was among the first apostles to be called by our Lord. James was the brother of the beloved disciple John. John and James were sons of Zebedee and Salome. Called with his brother John while they were working with their father, mending the nets. But their response was immediate. They left their father along with hired men and followed Jesus. James was present at the raising of Jairus' daughter when the Lord was asked to go and lay his hands on the sick daughter of Jairus. James was also present at the transfiguration of our Lord at Mount Tabor. The Acts of Apostles identified James as the first apostle to give his life as a martyr. He was killed by the command of King Herod. It is also great to note that on the mention of Jesus' death, James and John asked to remain close to Jesus. They asked to remain close to Jesus in his mission and establishing the kingdom of God. So we are privileged to celebrate this great saint and apostle. We can borrow from James and John to be courageous in our lives, to make reflected requests to be closer to Jesus, to be close to him. It may not be easy, but the path to this glory is by drinking the chalice of selfless sacrifice. So, a call to let go, a call to be ready to give our lives for our brothers and sisters. This is obtained by courageously following Jesus, listening to his voice, relying on his grace, and to be ready even to suffer and persecution. So we pray today for this great sacrifice of witnessing our faith, of abandoning certain hopes and dreams in our lives. So through the intercession of St. James, may we be firm and resolute in our faith. Let us turn our attention to the Lord's provision for us, entrusting these prayers to his will. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide and protect him in his blessed ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. For government leaders, may they be strengthened in their efforts to protect the dignity of all life from conception to natural death, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer injustice at the hands of others, may God's compassionate concern bring them healing and recompense. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this faith community, may Christ's example of service become the bedrock of our daily lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed, may the mercy of God soon usher them into eternal banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have asked us to pray for them, particularly those who are celebrating their birthday today, Lord, guide and grant them their hearts' desires and intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of salvation, in your goodness you draw us to yourself. Please listen to the prayers we have made for the salvation of the world. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Cleanse us, Lord, by the saving baptism of your Son's passion, so that on the feast of St. James, whom you willed to be the first among the apostles, to drink of Christ's chalice of suffering, we may offer a sacrifice pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim, Holy, Holy,
Holy,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Dolan, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
They drank the chalice of the Lord and became the friends of God. Let us pray. Help us, O Lord, we pray, through the intercessions of the blessed Apostle James, on whose feast day we have received with joy your holy gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We request Mirana and Lorena and Abit Raon to come forward. David. So God bless you. Have